Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 13 in our series, statelesscode.com WordPress. So now I'm going to try to see if I can build and deploy this theme to my version on Bluehost here. So what I'm going to try to do is enable SSH access. So go to Advanced SSH, Manage SSH keys, and then I'm going to import key, and we'll call this I'm not going to paste my private key or my password. All they need is the public key. And you don't even need to see my public key, so I'll pause, paste that in, hit the import button, and see how that works. So that seems to have worked. I took the the file you want to copy the contents are in your home directory. You'll have a .ssh directory, and then you want the contents of id_rsa.pub. Make sure you don't do id_rsa. Without the .pub, because then you will have compromised your private key, and everywhere you've got your public key, you'll have to go and regenerate your key and change it everywhere. So just be on the lookout to make sure that you are going to the correct file there. So I'm going to go back to manage keys, make sure it's not getting displayed here before I pause it and decide whether to display it or not. So we can see it's here, but the authorization status says not authorized. So let's take a look at there. I'm going to click on manage, and it notes not authorized. I'll hit the authorize button. Now it has been authorized. Go back. And so now the status is authorized. If I wanted to, I could view and download it. But now I should be able to, if we go to the help article here for connecting to SSH. So it's going to be your username at your IP, and it's going to be at port 2222 instead of the normal 22 that you would use to connect with SSH. So let's try that. And by default, your username is your username at your domain. So see if this works. Oh, port 2222. Yes. Oh, and it still requires me a password. So I'll pause and enter in that password. Too many authentication failures. That's interesting. Let me try my WordPress username. So let me try, because I haven't tried root yet. So I found my username, so it's statelf1, but let me see if I can figure out why it says shell access is not enabled. All right, so it looks like if I go to overall account here, SSH access, so it's authorized, but doesn't say how to enable it. All right, so it looks like I might need to do some, get the account verified in order to enable shell access. I'll pause and attempt that, let you know the results. All right, so it took about 15 minutes to get things straightened out, but I am now connected via SSH to my Bluehost server. So let's go back into my normal shell here. I'm in Stateless Sage, so I'm going to run now yarn build production. If we go to the code here, we still have the overall readme here, so yarn build colon production, so we'll do that. Finish. All right, so it looks like that was successful. Now I'm going to go back a directory. And then get my, so source will be, and my destination is going to be user at hostname. Colon. Directory. With a trailing slash. So I made the grave error of trying to do SCPR on that. So what I wound up doing is just zip recursive, and then the zip and the directory. And instead of taking half an hour to upload, it took 11 seconds. Let me see if I can I'm going to just I'm going to unzip. See what happens if I I'm gonna move it. Alright. Now I will move the file. Is a much more effective way to go about it. Let me see if this is workable now. So I will go into my sites here. Log into WordPress. And see if my theme exists. Stateless Sage. Let's try the live preview. Alright. So that is seeming to work. So that is giving me what I want. Site icon. I'll If they want 512 by 512, then I will get that. I'll pause and upload it. Alright, so we've got the 512. Select that. So, got site identity now. So that's all looking good. Menus. Deal with that a little later. Widgets. Deal with that a little later. Homepage settings. Make it latest posts for now. No additional CSS needed. All right, well, leave those alone for now. My archives, go to my posts, we will call this good enough. So I've got a theme. Let's go to our backlog. So install theme and plugins. Now it's time to get the plugins installed. So I have previously from my downloaded stuff, I've got the code plugin. So this is my localhost and the real one. So in my localhost, we've got the Enlighter code plugin. We'll get that to the real site. So go to plugins here. I think I've just got to get the file to the plugins directory. Alright, so those are the steps they give us. I will learn from my previous mistake to upload it as a zip. Plugins directory. Go to plugins. Refresh here. There is Enlighter, so we'll activate Enlighter. Now we will go to Enlighter in our menu here. Code ignition is two spaces, break line, enable, sure, we'll allow that. Theme, I wanted Monokai. Save my changes there. And then we'll go to my posts. Edit this. So now I want to pause and write some more content that uses the code highlighting functionality. All right, so I've got a couple of token code blocks in here. Preview in any tab. delete that fake comment. We can update this. I'm also going to make, so by default, you can just comment with an email address. So let's go back to our settings here. I want to make comments only by registered users. So if you care enough to comment, register as a user for statelesscode.com. So we'll do that. Our settings. I think I've still got my personal email in the general settings, so I'll pause and get to the right place. So I will note those. And I think that will get us to where we need to go. Check out some of the other things here. So for, no, I think default to month and name for now. We'll potentially modify that. I think you can override it on a post by post basis, but we'll do that. Take a look at this insights thing, see if there's anything valuable there. I'll pause and read it. So I don't think I'm going to get into that here for now. We'll stop there, pick up. I'll try to create an about page, and then we'll see about launching this bad boy.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.